Photographer Manuel Diaz and I heard explosions on the south side of the Capitol as we were editing videotape on the west side. What we heard and quickly saw others saw before us as the big rig driver drove straight into the Capitol.
All of a sudden, I looked to my left as I was passing the Capitol and saw a semi, what looked to me to be a semi truck, pulled into the step area. It looked like it had either backed in or smashed in. I didn't see any movement in the truck. And all of a sudden, boom, fire. And I thought, my God, they're bombing the Capitol.
I was standing on the corner of 11th and O, and I saw the semi go by really fast. And I was thinking, isn't there a stop sign there? I noticed it was going really, really fast. And then I heard this big boom, and I looked around the corner, and there's fire.
Similar account surfaced of the man behind the wheel driving around a several square block area, speeding down 11th to apparently gain momentum.
We seen a big trailer going by. He must have been going about 65 miles an hour. You know what? I didn't see him what direction he went, but I know when he hit N Street, there's only one way you could go, and that's going eastbound.
Minutes later, the big rig accelerated in this direction again, increasing its speed, going full bore into the state capitol.
This time he had to be flying at least 75 miles an hour, and he just went, took the stop sign. Luckily, the light rail stopped. If not, he would have took the light rail. He went through the stop sign, went through the lights. I seen him bounce once. The second bounce was straight into the Capitol, and it wasn't up in flame.
Authorities on hand described the driver's actions as a deliberate criminal act, which now leaves a footnote of suicide attack in the history of California's Capitol. I'm George Franco, KLVR 13 News.